Hi everyone, I'm here today with a Cinderella themed 12 by 12 double page scrapbook layout. And these are the two paper stacks that I'm using. The first one is the Die Cuts with a View Floral Fair paper stack. And the second one is a Disney themed mega paper pad. It doesn't have a name written on it, but I believe it's the girl stack. So the first thing I'm going to do is put together my photo frames. I have two 4x4 photo mats and one 4x6 photo mat on this page. And I have created these shapes in my Silhouette Studio. And I'm just going to cut them out and layer them together to create a frame to put around my photo. The next thing that I'm going to work on is my background pages. And I have created a couple of border strips. That green marbled paper is from the Floral Fair stack, as well as the pink marble paper and the floral. I'm using my Martha Stewart Deco Flower Punch Around the Page punch set to create the borders. And I've created four of those green border strips for each side of the layout. So now I'm just going to use some of my Zip Dry glue, and I'm going to adhere a green border to this blue paper. And this blue paper right here, it has some little white glass slippers, and that is from the Disney mega paper stack that I used. I think that's the only paper that I used from that stack. So I'm just going to adhere all my borders together. And these two borders with the blue strips are going to go at the bottom and the top of my layout. And I'm doing the same thing for this floral piece. I have a larger floral piece, and that's going to go in the middle of the pink marbled paper. So once I have all my pieces put together, I'm going to adhere one strip at the top of the layout. Now I've cut the pink marbled paper down 1/4 inch on three sides, but I did not cut down my border strips. What I like to do is just adhere them and get them in the right position. And then once I adhere my the pink piece to my 12 by 12 craft cardstock, I'll just take the whole thing and trim it down with my paper trimmer to make sure that I get a really nice flush edge. It seems that 12 by 12 papers never exactly measure up to 12 by 12, so I like to trim them down so that everything fits exactly. I have already put together the second side of my layout, so now I'm just bringing it in so that I can line everything up and hopefully get my background pieces lined up as precisely as possible. It's always a little off, but I try. And now I'm just going to adhere this whole piece to my craft cardstock background. And then once I get it adhered down, I will trim down the excess border strips. The glue that I'm using is the Zip Dry adhesive, and most of the video is just me trying to get my glue to come out and actually squeeze onto the page. It could be a little bit cumbersome to work with, but I really like it because when you put it down on your paper, you can shift your papers around. It's a slower dry glue, so you have some time to manipulate things and get them right where you want them. And once it dries, it holds really well. So now I'm going to bring in my die cuts, and most of my die cuts are from the Disney Happily Ever After Cricut cartridge. All of them except for the title. The Happily Ever After title came from the Cricut Storybook Cricut cartridge. There is a Happily Ever After title on the Happily Ever After cartridge, but it was longer in length and it just didn't fit right on my page, and I like the look of this title better anyway. To me, it had more of a detailed look to it. So this is the Cinderella and Prince Charming cut, where they're wearing their wedding outfits. And I took some crystal rhinestones and added to Cinderella's tiara, and I added a couple to the carriage and the clock, and I think the slipper, which you'll see a little bit later. So I'm just adhering my photo mats down. I went ahead and put my die cuts down so that I could place my photo mats around them and make sure I had everything in the right place. And now I'm just going to take a little bit of my ATG tape, and I'm going to sort of lightly tack the frame into place. And I'm not adhering it all the way because when I go to put photos on, I want to take the frame completely off, put the photo down, and then adhere the frame on top of it. So I don't want to permanently adhere it just yet. So all of my die cuts have been inked. I use different colored inks on all the pieces. You know, like I would use a darker blue on the blue pieces, a darker purple on the purple to give it a shaded effect. And then my papers, I used a brown tone on the backgrounds to give it more of like a vintage aged look. And then all of my die cuts are popped up on a single layer of foam. And I just like to buy the large pack of, it's called Fun Foam. You can find it in the kids section at craft stores, but you can cut the pieces to whatever size that you need. They are adhesive on one side and then you just add adhesive on the other side. I have been using that for years and it's my favorite. I like the height that it gives. It doesn't make it too tall. But it also, you can cut the pieces to the size that you need. It's not little tiny dots of foam. So I'm finishing up my final photo frame. And now I will start adhering all of my die cuts. And sometimes I use the liquid zip dry glue for this, but sometimes I just use my ATG tape. It just depends. So now I'm bringing in some of my smaller die cuts. I have a pumpkin. I have the invitation to the ball and the glass slipper. And there are a couple die cuts. I think it's the pumpkin and the clock that I added some embossing to. And I just used my Cricut Lots of Dots Cuddlebook folder. Just to give a little extra dimension. And that is my completed layout. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. Have a nice day.